let's get into some extreme close-ups here. Today we're going to focus on the Battle of Los Angeles. We'll go with the Lakers first. We were sort of talking about them. We'll go right back to them. Let's take a really in-depth look at the Lakers, who actually haven't made a lot of moves this offseason. It's arguable because obviously Odom's gone and they tried to make that big CP3 trade that failed, but they are largely the same team that they were last year. What do you think this year? Is the prognosis good?
I think it's a little bit below what it was last year. I mean, last year, I think most people thought that they were absolutely competing again to win their third straight championship. Boy, did they hit the wall in the playoffs against the Mavericks.
Oh, yeah.
And I think one of the things that was really exposed was their point guard play and that they didn't get enough production out of the three spot with the artist formerly known as Ron Artest, who's now Meta World Peace. He's no longer a real solid offensive contributor. He had a couple of years there where he was, but he's primarily a defensive guy at this point. Derek Fisher's been in the NBA for a very long time, and they have Steve Blake rotating in and out of that point guard spot. They really coveted Chris Paul for obvious reasons. But now that he's not there, I'm wondering what kind of move they could get in the point guard spot. You can argue that they don't need a lot of offensive production out of the three spot with Ron Artest because of Kobe's continued dominance as one of the best players in the league. That point guard spot's real iffy, Matt, and I don't know if they're going to have enough offensive punch all around from the perimeter to be that contending team again. And then, of course, probably the biggest question outside of personnel or just in general, what is the offense going to look like? They're no longer going to be running the triangle offense with Mike Brown on board. That's going to be a dramatic shift for a team that has run that offense for many, many years now. I think that they come into the season, and it's very difficult to really forecast exactly where they're going to go.
Yeah, I'm forecasting a pretty bleak season for the Lake Show this year. I mean, you know, I think that they're still going to, well, it's a 66-game season. You know, they'll probably still win, like, 45 games, maybe, you know, or maybe more. Kobe is not the Kobe of 5 years ago, right? I mean, I don't know that Kobe can carry this offense. I mean, He hasn't been trying to carry this offense, except, you know, when it really matters, the ball goes in Kobe's hands. That's kind of how it works. But, you know, I think he's into this whole score 20 points, you know, two or three steals, you know. It just seems like he doesn't want to do that anymore. Pau Gasol is very unhappy. I was listening to some reports on this morning, people saying that Gasol, as we were saying before, that Lamar Odom was very demoralized by that CP3 trade. Pau Gasol is actually still there. He's still playing for the Lakers, and he's demoralized. He doesn't like it there. He feels not respected, that they don't like his work, that they don't want him on the team because they tried to get rid of him. And so he's not happy, and that doesn't bode well for a player who basically had a terrible season last year. Well, at least underachieved, which is probably an understatement in and of itself. So Gasol is an unknown, and I don't think he's going to have a great year. At least it doesn't look that way. Bynum may not be healthy, may be healthy. Right now he is. I think he still has to sit out the first five games of the season. If I remember correctly, I think that was his punishment. But he obviously, the off-the-court concerns or on-the-court, pushing people around, whatever he's doing. Kobe's Kobe. He's going to lead the team, right? But then you've got Fisher, and you've got Meta World Peace. Like, what are these guys going to do? And then, you know, you've got Matt Barnes behind Ron Artest, and you've got Steve Blake behind Fisher. This team just looks, you know, more than aging. The Boston Celtics are aging but can be very productive. I don't know that I feel this way about the Lakers. I feel like there's some major holes at the Meta World Peace position, and the fact that Gasol is underperforming, I don't see how the Lakers are going to have a great year this year. I mean, they're old. They've got a new coach, a new system, a completely different system than they've ever played in and won championships in. I don't see how they're going to have a big year this year. they may not be a top five team in the West, and it's going to be all that we're talking about if that actually happens. I mean, but you'd like to think that Kobe can pull away. Do you think that he will? Am I wrong? You think they're going to win 50, 55 games somehow? That would be a lot of games to win, a 66-game season. But
not that many. I think that here's the thing with this team. If they stay out of injuries, they still have the ability to be a top three team in the West. But do I think that they will be right now? No, I don't. And it's because of the point guard position. Fisher is just not going to be able to give you much more than 30 minutes a night at this point in his career. And like you said, you know, where is the rest of the offensive punch coming from on the perimeter? If Gasol plays like he really wants it, and if Andrew Bynum does the same, and you know they're staying out of injuries, they still have one of the better front courts in the NBA. But I definitely think there will be a move made at some point. Kobe Bryant is unafraid of telling leadership, "Hey, make something happen." And I think he's very upset. I mean, look at what was being said in the media very openly by Kobe Bryant after the Chris Paul deal did not go through. I mean, this is a team that clearly felt that they needed some additions and that things needed to be mixed up a little bit. You get swept out of the playoffs in four straight games. You know, all of a sudden, Kobe Bryant seeing the window close ever more on his career. He's still probably got another couple of years left in him. But, I mean, this is a year where he wants to make another push for a title. And I got to say, I changed my opinion a little bit more after I saw the body language and some of the things that were said by Lakers players about just how unhappy they were that the Paul deal did not go through. I think that Kobe Bryant was letting everybody know pretty openly that he's not exactly thrilled about, you know, the point guard spot and maybe some of the rest of their perimeter play.
Yeah, I don't think it's going to be a good season for them, but we will see. I mean, I said it last year. They said, no, we can win with this team next year. We'll give it another shot. I was in the camp of, you got to shake this thing up. And I would honestly like to see them ship Gasol and Bynum over to Orlando, get Howard. I think that they should make a play, honestly, for Baron Davis. I absolutely think that they should make a play for Baron Davis. I mean, who knows? This conversation about the Lakers could be completely different when we have it at Christmas time, which is now pretty close, huh? But still, I think that, well, let's say by the All-Star break, there's a very good chance that this team could look completely different, because I think they're going to figure out that this group here, they're not going to be able to win a lot of games and certainly not make a run unless Kobe can do it all. And I don't think he can anymore.